does she remember September 53, when her husband Pat of just 3 years sailed out across the sea? To work was his intention, to send a few bob home, so his wife and son could pack their bags and join him cross the foam. Well, he worked the hours the good Lord sent, building up and tearing down. His name was Paddy Phelan, and he came from Portleash town. She suffered through the 60s, he finally made it back. He was happy to be home again, although the work was slack. Until one day the sun came in, and he told his parents, dear, I'm going to work in London town, I can't find work back here. She suffered through the 80s, with times both bad and good. In 82, her first grandson was born in Cricklewood. Though she heard from them quite often, with letters and the phone, she hoped that things would turn out right and they would come back home. Well, he worked the hours the good Lord sent, building up and tearing down. His name was Paddy Phelan, and he came from Portleash town. Now in the house alone at night, this woman old and grey, when her husband Pat through sickness fell and now lies in the clay, she likes to show the pictures to the people who call around. That's my grandson Paddy Phelan, and my son from Portleash town. Now we're in the new millennium, and we haven't changed in years. Our seaport full of heartache, and our airport full of tears. Perhaps someday we'll turn it round and bring them all back home. No more will Irish men have to sail across the foam. Well, he worked the hours the good Lord sent, building up and tearing down. His name was Paddy Phelan, and he came from Portleash town. His name was Paddy Phelan, and he came from Portleash town.